नियतिकृतनियम रहितां श्लाघैकमयीं अनन्य परतन्त्रां नवरस रुचिरां निर्मितिं आददति भारती कवेर जयति. लेट्स लुक एट व्यतिरेक अलंकार टुडे एंड या आई सी हाउ मच ऑफ इट आई कैन डू. देर आर अबाउट 8 एग्जांपल्स इन दिस. लास्ट टाइम आई स्टार्टेड दिस आई जस्ट वांट टू से इट वंस मोर so that there is a continuity and you also understand what it is. Upamanad anyasya vyatirekaha saeva saha anyasya upameyasya yadi upamanad upameyasya adhikyam varnyate tatra vyatireka alankaraha. According to Ruyaka, he also gives another type of vyatireka where upamanasya upameyat adhikyam. But the very point of an upamana, the definition of an upamana itself is lost, because upamanam is the standard of comparison. We always know that in given any situation, the moon is going to be very attractive for us, right? But and we also say that it is very beautiful to look at. The woman may not have that beauty always, every day, you don't know. But it is a standard of comparison that we use. And negating or the, he doesn't, how to say that? He doesn't have any problems with the, Mamata doesn't have any problems with Ruyaka's Lakshanam. More than he has a problem with the Udaharana Shloka that he gives. The Udaharana Shloka that Ruyaka gives doesn't have any adhikyam that is shown. It is only Yavvanagata Asthairyam that is being shown. Kshinaha Kshinopi Shashi Bhuyo Bhuyo Abhivardate Satyam. When the moon decreases, there is a hope that it is going to grow again during Shukla Paksham. But Virama Prasida He Sundari Yavvanam Anativarti Yatam Tu Yavvanam Anativarti. Sorry, Anivarti. Yatam Tu Yavvanam, when the youth has gone, it is not going to come back like the moon. So it is best that you make use of this opportunity that we have together and be nice to me. So, or let's be nice to each other. Virama prasida he sundari. It shows more of the yavanagatam asthairyam than, you know, trying to show that the upamanam is better than the upameyam. The example is a problem for Mammata. Then he goes to differentiate vyatireka, the classifications of vyatireka. So there are two hetus that are possible for vyatireka. One is Upameya gatam utkarsham or upamana gatam apakarsham. By pointing out a deficiency in the upamana, you can show that the upameya is better than the upamana, or you can show an added quality in the upameya which by understanding is absent in the upamanam, and hence you are showing that the varnaniya vastu is better than the upamanam, than the standard of comparison. So there are two reasons for showing that the upameya is better than upamana. So vyatirekasya dvau hetu staha upameya gatam utkarsham atha utkarshaha athava apamana upamana gatam apakarshaha dvayor uktihi athava ekatarasya uktihi athava dvayoho api anuktihi iti veda chatushtayam. तदनन्तरम् उपमेय उपमान उपमेयभावे शाब्देन प्रतिपादिते आर्थेन क्रमेण उक्ताः अथवा आक्षिप्ते इति. यू हैव 12 अदर डिविजन्स्. ऐ जस्ट् वांटेड् टु रिकलेक्ट् दि उपमा अलङ्कार दट् वी डिड् बिफोर्. So I just put in that slide. If there is an issue, you can always go back to the first lesson in Alankara to understand what is Shrauti and Arthi, because this Shrauti and Arthi aspect is being used in Vyatireka for the different divisions. Because you have an Upamanam and an Upameyam, you are comparing the two of them and saying one is better. So the comparison is Upama. And that upama can be of two types. We saw Shrauti and Arthi. It is Shrauti when you say Iva, when you use the Shabda Iva or Va, Vat, etc. And they are used in Prathama Vibhakti. बट् द मीनिङ्ग् इस् आक्चुलि तत्र तस्य इव कमलस्य इव. सो मुखं चन्द्र इव इत्युक्ते चन्द्रस्य आकर्षणम् इव आकर्षणं मुखे अपि विद्यते. और् कमलस्य आकर्षणमेव आकर्षणं, कमलस्य कान्तिरिव कान्तिः मुखे अपि वर्तते इति सम्बन्धः तत्र प्रतिपाद्यते. सो देट् बिकम्स् श्रौति. वि हियर् देट् कम्पेरिसन्. सो इव इस् शब्द उपात्तं साम्यम्. अण्ड् वत् प्रत्यय बै द सूत्रं तत्र तस्य इव आल्सो बिकम्स् शब्द उपात्तं साम्यम्. In the same way, when you use words like tulyam, tena tulyam mukham, chandrena mukham tulyam vartate. There we do not say chandrasya kantiriva tulyam. We don't use an expression like that. So tulyadi shabde to arthi. It is arthi upama. Okay, arthavat samyam bhavati tatra. So artham samyam yatra vidyate tatra tulyadi prayogaha. Or tena tulyam kriya ched vatih, and vat pratyaya is used in the same manner to indicate tulyam. If that vat pratyayam is used, that is also artham samyam. Just to, if none of these are used, there is no eva, no tulyam, no sadrisham, no vat pratyayah, any of these things, then it is akshiptam samyam. So based on these three samyam, we have the divisions of that. सो द्वयोः उक्तिः अनुक्तिः, एकस्य उक्तिः अपकर्षस्य उक्तिः अथवा उत्कर्षस्य उक्तिः. दिस् इस् फोर् टैप्स्. दीस् फोर् आर् अगेन् डिवैडेड् इन् टु त्री. ईच् वन् आफ़् दीस् फोर् डिविशन्स् आर् डिवैडेड् इन् टु त्री. वेन् द साम्यम् इस् शाब्दं, साम्यम् इस् आर्थम्, आर् साम्यम् इस् आक्षिप्तम्. द विशेषणस् दट् वि यूस् केन् हाव् श्लेष आर् नाट्. सो श्लिष्टम् अश्लिष्टं. सो टोटलि 24 divisions are there. In that we saw the first one, which is asimatra sahayasya prabhutari parabhave anyatuchya janasya iva na smayaha asya mahadritehe. Asya mahadritehe, for this valorous king, asimatra sahayasya, who is just having a sword for his sahayam companion, prabhutari parabhave, in suppressing all his many enemies, prabhuta ari parabhave, in the matter of defeating every enemy, anya tuchya janasya iva, like another inferior person, asya na smayaha, asya rajnyaha smayaha na vidyate, garvaha nasti, is not arrogant. So the raja is the upameyam. Anya tuchya janasya iva is used here. So anya janaha is your upamana. We have mahadhritittvam for this raja, prakrita raja. So that is a utkarsha that is being said. Apakarsham is tuchcha janasya, anya tuchcha janasya. So he is the quality of being tuchcham or apakarsham is being said there. Okay, you're showing that he is inferior. And eva is the shabda that is used, so it is shabdam samyam. There are no visheshanas which is slesha, no double meaning. Hence it is a aslishta. Both of the hetu are said. If at some point, if you remove any of one, if you remove tuchchatvam, then it becomes one type. If you remove mahadhritittvam, then it becomes another type. If mahadhriti and tuchcha both are not mentioned, then it is the third, fourth variety. So all four can be said here. Evam anyeshu api atraiva tuchcha iti mahadhritehe iti anayoho paryayena, one after the other, ekasya anuktau, or yugapativa anupadane dvayorapi anupadane anuktau sati anyat bhedatrayam. So uktancha atra ekam bheda, ekaha bhedaha, anyat bhedatrayam api atra vaktum shakyate. You can if you remove one of the adjectives or both. Evam anyeshu api drashtavyam. In any other examples that we see later also, you have to apply this formula in the same manner for the three types. Next one is very similar. He wants to show the artham samyam. I told you the vat is used tena tulyam, with the sutra tena tulyam. So atimatra sahayopi प्रभूत अरिपराभवे नैव अन्यतुच्छ जनवत् सगर्वः अयं महाधृतिः. There is no Shashti Vibhakti here. So it is a direct comparison, but with artham. That vat is used instead of tulyam. Asimatra sahayas, sahayaha api. Even though I am this Raja, asimatra sahayaha. He has only the sword as a companion. Prabhuta hari parabhave in suppressing all the enemies. Anya tuccha janavatu. Just like another inferior person, sa garvaha na naiva ayam. He does not have any garva, arrogance. Same you can say both mahadhritittvam is the upameyagatama utkarsha that is mentioned, and upamanagata apakarshaha to tuchatvam atra uktam. Vat iti pratyaha tena tulyam. We saw that before, right? What is that sutram? Tena. Tena tulyam kriyache duvatihi iti sutrena vat pratyaha tasmat artham samyam atra vidyate ekasyapi visheshana kasyapi visheshanasya atra slishtam padam upayukta. So aslishtam. The next one is also aslishtam, where it is akshiptam samyam. We don't have eva tulyam or any of those. Iyam sunayana dasikrita tamarasa shriya ananena akalankena jayati indum kalankinam. Iyam sunayana, this lovely eyed lady, dasi krita tamarasa shriya, her face, so ananena, ananena has its adjective as dasi krita tamarasa shriya, tamarasa kamalam, kamalasya shrihi ananena dasi krita. So her face has made the lotus's beauty as her dasi. So dasi krita tamarasa shriya, tamarasasya kamalasya shobha dasi krita yena tena ananena kadamasti ananam akalankam. There is, it's a spotless face, there is no kalankam in the face. So kam jayati ananena indum jayati indushcha kalanki. Sakalankam indum jayati. There is a kalankam, the spotted moon, whereas by her spotless face, she wins over, she defeats the chandra. Okay, here, aslishtam, none of the visheshanas have slesha. Both hetu are mentioned. What are the hetus? Akalankena, spotlessness. The akalankitvam is upameye utkarshaha, upameye katam, upameya gataha utkarshaha, upamana gataha apakarshaha tu kalanki chandraha ityatra. Samya vachaka padam na uktamatra. So there is no eva, tulyam or any of those sort. Just by saying jayati, that vyatireka is shown. Ananena sa chandram jayati, which means there is a vyatireka, that is the upameyam, varnaniya vastu upamanat adhikya darshanam vartate atra. Next one, we start for the slishta bheda, where everything else is going to be now slesha yuktam. Jitendriyataya samyak vidyavriddha nishevinaha ati gadha gunasya asya na abjavat bhangura gunaha. So this is shabdam samyam abjavat ityatra abjasya gunaha iva gunaha asya rajnyaha na santi. So that tasya tulyam tasya iva tatra. I keep forgetting that sutram. Atatra tasya iva ityanena ivarthe vihitaha vat. Jitendriyataya samyak vidya vriddha nishevinaha asya ati gadha gunasya asya jitendriyataya abjavat banguraha gunaha na santi. Asya rajnyaha, this king, how is he? Two adjectives for him. One, samyak ati gadha gunasya. First, he has a lot of gadham, deep, unfathomable, something which you cannot even understand. Tadrisha gunaha asya santi. So, adi gadha gunasya asya rajnyaha. Further, samyaka vidya vriddha nishayavinaha. Because he has great qualities in him which nobody can understand, he also he serves Vidyavriddha, he serves scholars, the learned, Samyak. Samyak Vidyavriddha Nishevinaha, he serves all the learned very well. Then, owing to, you know, Jitendriyataya, because he has control over his senses, Abjavat Asya Gunaha Bhanguraha Nasanti. So, Abjavat, like a lotus, his gunaha, his qualities are not bhangura. Bhangura meaning bhanguratvam, quick to destruction. That is, it quickly vanishes away. Now, here the word guna is slishtam because guna also means sutram. It also means gunaha, panditiyadi gunaha. So, the upameyam here is actually rajnyasya gunaha. अब्जस्य गुणाः इव न सन्ति इति तत्र औपम्यं दृश्यते किन्तु उपमानात् उपमेयस्य आधिक्यमपि दृश्यते न कमलस्य गुणा इव न सन्ति राज्ञः गुणाः इति राज्ञः गुणानाम् आधिक्यं दृश्यते तस्मात् व्यतिरेकालङ्कारः नाउ हाउ डस इट वर्क हियर सो गुणा मीन्स सूत्रम सूत्रम मीन्स थ्रेड और मृणालम The lotus stalk. So the lotus stalk, inside the lotus stalk, as soon as you open it, there will be a thread sort of thing, or you can take out from even the, you know, banana tree, the thunder, we can take out strings from that. But that is not so thin that it will break easily. But the sutram that we get from the kamalam, the lotus, is very thin and it is bhanguram, kshana bhanguram. It can very easily break. But his qualities are not something which will easily vanish away because of Jitendriyataya. The only place where he connects it is the word guna, which is slishta, which has double meaning. That's the only part which gives us that connection. The rest will not fit any of those abjam. It is all fitting only the king here. So Atigada Gunasya Asya Samyak Vidya Vriddha Nishevinaha, one who serves the learned, one who is always devoted to the learned people, scholars, because he has control over his sense organs, his qualities are always thiram. They are not bhanguram. Okay. So Atigadhatvam is the Upameyagata Utkarshaha, Bhanguratvantu Upamanagata Apakarshaha. Ivarte Vatpratyaha Api Upattaha. Next is artham samyam slishtam again double meaning akhanda mandalaha shriman pashya esha prithivipatihi na nishakaravat jatu kala vaikalyam agataha another simple way of differentiating between shabdam and artham I told this during upama also just a reminder if the upameya is in shashti vibhakti in Vat Pratyayam, especially in Vat Pratyayam, it will be easier to understand. Okay. And here, if it is not in Shashti Vibhakti and it is just direct, then it is Artham. So, Akanda Mandalaha, Shriman, Pashya Esha Prithivipatihi. Pashya, see this Prithivipati, Esha Prithivipatihi, this Lord of the Earth. He is Akhanda Mandalaha, Sampurna Mandalaha Asti. Mandalam means his Chakravarti Mandalam. There is no break in his kingdom. He just rules without any break in his kingdom. So Akhanda Mandalaha. Every Chakravarti actually comes and relies on this king for a support. So Esha Prithivipatihi, Shriman, he is very prosperous. Akhanda Mandalaha, he has you can say something like unbroken stretch of a kingdom. How is he? Kala vaikalyam na agataha. Jatu, never ever has his kala, the 64 arts that he pursues, tesham, tasam, vaikalyam na agataha. Vikalata. Vikalata means kala is, that is, vikalam is, there is, it is always full. He always practices his kala. There is no breakage to his kala at all. Whereas Nishakara, Chandra, there is always, he is never always full. There is never Purnima continuously for 30 days in this world. So there is always a kala missing in him. Kala is a part, bhaga. So Chandrasya shodasha bhaganam madhye eka kala pratyekasmin dine na vartate. So one by one, that kala, that digit of the moon keeps reducing or it keeps increasing. So he misses out on that. So kala vaikalyam tu nishakarasya asti. Kintu chatushishti kalanam vaikalyam ragni na santi. Nripe na santi. Okay. Na asti. Okay. Akanda mandalaha shriman pashya. So he has never been without luster. Always he is shriman. Whereas Nishakaraha, in every aspect, the Upamanam Chandraha is lesser or inferior to the king. So Upameyasya Utkarshaha Akanda Mandalatvena Atra Nirdishtaha Upamanagata Apakarshastu Kala Vaikalyam Agataha Iti Nishakara Pakshe Api Apakarshaha Drishyate. Okay. That word kala indicates both chatushishti kala, 64 arts, and the kala, digits of a chandra. Is it clear? Next is mala, vyatirekam. Mala rupam, just like how in mala upama rupakam, mala prativastu upamavat, mala vyatirekaha api sambhavati, tasyapi bhedaha evam uhyaha. For the different divisions of this mala vyatirekam also, you have to understand the same manner, like in 24 types that we saw, the same 24 types can apply to mala vyatirekam also. So which means you will have 24 types of normal vyatireka and 24 types of mala vyatirekam. Totally there will be 48 types. Luckily we have only 8 examples that he gives. Dingmatram udakhriyate yatha. So he gives three examples. One is artham samyam. The second is akshiptam samyam. The third is also akshiptam samyam, but it is just a different way of akshepaha. The third serves as where he doesn't even say jayati, atirichyate. These words are also not used there. Once we look at the examples, you'll understand. So, haravat na vishama drishtihi, harivat na vibho vidhuta vidata vrishaha, ravivat na cha ati dussahakara tapita bhuhu kadachit asi. Hey vibho, Rajan, you never have vishama drishti like hara. Haravat, like Shiva, you don't have vishama drishti. Vishama drishti here has two meanings. One is Vishama is odd number. Haraha Shivasya, there are odd number of eyes. Trini netrani santi. Whereas you here samadrishtihi, vishamadrishtihi. Samadrishtihi equanimity. Vishamadrishtihi means partiality. You are not partial like Shiva. So here, however, you have to explain it as only tava vishamadrishtihi nasti, haravat shivavat vishamadrishtihi, parameshwaravat vishamadrishtihi nasti. So Shiva pakshetu trini akshini, whereas in Raja pakshetu vishamadrishtihi iti, there is no partiality among people. Harivat na vidhuta vitata vrishaha. I think vrisha means dharma. Let me just check that. Prushahana dharmunda nanikre. Vrishaha means dharma. Correct. Vrishaha is dharma. Vitata is mahan. And vidhutaha kshiptaha nashtaha. So you are not like Hari. Vidhuta vitata vrishaha. Vidhuta vitata vidhuta nashta dharma. Mahana dharmaha asti. And in your kingdom, you are never opposed to dharma, or you never destroy dharma in your rule. You are not a destroyer of dharma. You are not a destroyer of vrisha like Krishna, like Hari. Vrisha also means Vrishasura. Vrishasura is Arishtasura, Mayasuta. He is Maya's son. The Vrishamayatmajat Vishvato Bhayat. In Gopika Gita, there is a shlokam. Vishajalapyayat Vyalarakshasat Varshamarutahat Vaidutanalat Vrishamayatmajat. So Vrishaha, yaha Maya Atmajaha Asti, Tasya Tasmat Vayam Rakshitaha, He Prabho. Rakshito Muhuhu. We Rakshita Muhuhu. We are again and again, we are being protected by you from all the different Rakshasas who have come, Asuras who have come and tortured us, who have troubled us. Gopika Gita, this beautiful section that is. Vrishamayatmajat. From Vrishasura, you have protected us. So Harihi Vidhuta Vitata Vrishaha. He has destroyed Vrishasura. He takes the form of a bull and comes and troubles Gokulam. And Krishna takes care of it again. He had destroyed Vrishasura, whereas here he does not destroy Vrisha, meaning the king does not destroy or remove Dharma. He is not moved, he has not removed himself away from the path of Dharma. So next is Ravivatu Nacha Ati Dussaha Kara Tapita Bhuhu Kadachit Tvam Na Asi. Anytime you are not like this. How? Ravivat, Suryavat, Ati Dussaha Kara Tapita Bhuhu. Surya, what he does is, he troubles Tapita, he troubles the Bhumi with his Ati Dussaha Kara. Kara ityukte Kiranam. With his Kiranam, the rays which are Dussaha, which is not tolerable, intolerable rays, you cannot tolerate his rays at all. And with those rays, he creates heat in this earth. But you do not oppress the world. Nacha tvam tapita bhuhu kena ati dussaha karena. Karaha here means tax. You do not oppress the people with difficult taxation or too much tax. Whereas the Surya, he troubles the earth with his unbearable rays. Okay. So here again, sama drishti, vishama drishti, and sama drishti or dharmikaha tvam and karena tvam bhumim na tapayasi ityadi utkarshaha, upameyagata utkarshaha is not being said here. It is not directly mentioned here. There is only the mention of upamanagata apakarshaha. Haraha vishama drishtihi. But one Vyakhyanam says, from Vishama Drishti, Samadrishtitvam is Akshiptam, so both are mentioned. You can say however you want, you can explain it. Okay? So, Upamane, Vishama Drishtitvadi, Apakarshaha, Upattaha. Vat Pratyam, so Haravat, Harivat, all these are used in the sense of Artham Samyam. The Samyam is mentioned here. And each of those visheshana is slishta. Sorry. The next one is Nityodita Pratapena Triyama Milita Prabhaha Bhaswata Anena Bhupena Bhaswan Esha Vinirjitaha. Esha Bhaswan Bhupena Bhaswata Bhupena Vinirjitaha. Eshaha Bhaswan Akashe Drishtaha Bhaswan Suryaha Vinirjitaha Jitaha Eshaha Parajitaha. So he has been defeated by whom? Anena Bhupena Anena Bhumipalena Rajnya Akashe Drishtaha Akashe Sthitaha Suryaha Vinirjitaha. Kathamasti Eshaha Raja Bhaswata Anena Bhupena. He is also Bhaswan. He is also with luster, Kantimata, Athava Ravi, Ravirupena Rajnya. You're superimposing the quality of Surya onto the king here. Right? So, and it is Klesham. this Surya has defeated that Surya. The king who is a Surya has defeated the original Surya, sun. So Bhaswata anena bhupena eshaha bhasvan vinirjitaha. What are the other two? But the other adjective for the king is Nitya Udita Pratapena. He is always, his pratapam is parakramam Nitya Uditam. It is ever present. With his glory ever present, this king, who is also lustrous, who has got a great kanti, Bhaswata Anena Bhupena, Kaha Jitaha Triyama Milita Prabhaha Bhaswan. He closes Milita Prabha, his Prabha, his Kanti, Surya's Kanti is absent, Militam. It is completely covered during Triyama, during the Tri Yama, the time. The Triyama also means night because she is divided into three parts. And then the fourth part is Ushakkala. So Triyama Esha Ratrihi, Ratrau Suryasya Prabha Milita. It is completely covered. Now, this Prabhamilitattvam is an Apakarsham that is mentioned. Upamanagata Apakarshaha is mentioned. Upameyagata Utkarshaha Nitya Udita Pratapaha is present. Whereas for the Surya, Pratapaha means Prakrishtatapaha, which is absent. It is not Nitya Uditam. It is not present 24 by 7. The Surya is not there. Right, so whereas for the king, Nitya Udita Pratapaha, Bhaswata also means Kantimata and Ravi Rupa, but it can be for both. Again, there is Klesha, both Apakarsham is also mentioned, Utkarsham is also mentioned, and then the Samyam, there is no Iva, nothing of that sort is mentioned, there is only Nivenirjitaha is mentioned. I don't think this is Mala Vyatirekam. One minute. Let me just check this. There is no mala here. This is just clear vyatirekam, that's all. Okay, there is no mala vyatirekam here. I'm sorry. You should remove that. Okay. The next one is, again, there is no mala in that also. Here, there is only Akshiptam Samyam. There are no Iva, Tulya, etc. There is also that Jayati, Vinirjitaha, even that is not present in this shloka. Even there, you can have a Vyatireka Alankara. Even without Upamanam, sorry, even without Iva, Samyavachaka Shabda, without Jaya Shabda, Adhikya Shabdadi, you can still have Vyatireka. Okay. Swachha Atmata Guna Samullasita Indu Bimbam Bimba Prabhadharam Akritrima Akritrima Hridya Gandham Yunam Ativa Pibatam Rajaneshu Yatra Trishnam Jahara Madhu Na Ananam Angananam Atra Ivadinam Tulyadinam Chapadanam Abhave Api Slishta Visheshanaihi Akshiptayeva Upama Pratiyate. The meaning of the shloka is, I will look at the Vyakhyanam and say it's very clear in the Vyakhyanam. Nirjita Jayati Ityadi Shabda Abhave Api. That is Mukhyam in this example. That is why he has given this example here. So Swachha Yatra Vasante Rajanishu. It's a description of Madhumasam. And in the night during Vasantaritu, Yatra Vasante, Vasantaritu. Rajaneeshu during the night, Yunam Pibatam Yunam Ativa Trishnam Jahara Madhu Pibatam Yunam or Pibatam Yunam Trishnam Madhu Jahara. Madhu is again for both Madhumasam and Madhu, this Madhyapanam, alcohol. So someone who drinks wine. Pibatam yunam, madhu pibatam yunam, trishnam jahara. As they drink wine, this wine removes their desire. So they don't feel like the whatever desire they had for drinking, or when the spring season started, they wanted to enjoy. So during the night, Rajaneeshu, their desire to drink was removed by the wine which was present, and so they drank it. How was that wine? First we will look at that part and then go to angananam ananam na jahara. So madhu yunam pibatam yunam trishnam jahara. This madhu wine removed the trishna, desire for the yunam, for the youth, young people who were drinking during the night. That madhu is like swachha atmata guna samullasita indu bimbam. The wine is in a cup and the moon is reflected inside the cup. So it is the moonlight, it is during night and the cup is so clear, swachha atmata. The wine is also very clear and so it can reflect the samullasita indu bimbam. It has the indu bimbam atra madhupane pratibimbitam asti. Bimba prabha adharam. Bimba prabha adharam, it's Bimba prabha adharam. I'll have to traverse through all this here. Prabha kantihi dharati. Bimba prabha dharam. Bimba prabha adharam will go for the ananam. Ladies' faces. That's why I got confused. So bimba prabha dharam. Bimba phalasya kantim dharati. So wine is very dark in color, reddish in color. So it is like the bimba kovai parambo. Like the inside of a, you know, tinda. I don't know if you've seen that. Koka, we say. That inside is very reddish in color when it is a fruit, when it is really ripe. So, bimba phalasya prabha kantihi kantim madhu dharati. Tadrisham madhu pibatam yunam. Next is akritrima hridya gandham. There is a natural fragrance to that wine. It is not kritrimam. It is not man-made fragrance. Nobody has infused it with any fragrance. It is just a natural fragrance. And because of that, it is a very attractive fragrance that is there. Akritrima, natural, hridya, attractive, gandha yuktam madhu. Pibatam yunam, trishnam jahara. Etadrisha madhu. Yunam trishnam jahara vasantarutau rajanishu ratrishu. It removed the desire that was there for the young people. Now, natu anan angananam ananam na jahara. But angananam ananam trishnam na jahara. Yunam trishnam na jahara. But the ladies' faces, angananam ananam, when they were enjoying the night with the ladies, those ladies' face did not remove their desire, did not satisfy them. That is, they wanted to keep on appreciating the ladies' face. When you start drinking, there is a limit to drinking and you easily get satisfied. Whereas here, they were not easily satisfied by looking at the ladies' faces. They wanted to keep on looking at them again and again. So, angananam ananam pakshe. So, madhu yunam trishnam jahara pakshe angananam ananam tu yunam trishnam na jahara. It did not. So, it is implied that the ananam, the face, mukham, angananam mukham is better than madhu. It is implied here. There is no jayati, no jitaha, nirjitaha, atava jayati, iti pada, anupadane api vyatirekaha atra drishyate. Now, the three adjectives, visheshanam, will fit angananam ananam also. Swachha atmata guna. Their faces have a very clear, spotless quality. So they have samullasita indu bimbam. It shines like indu bimba. It shines like the moon. So their face is like the moon because of the spotless quality, swacham. Bimba prabha adharam. Their lips are like the bimba fruit. Akritrima hridya gandham. They have a natural fragrance in their face. The Uttamajati stri are supposed to have a natural fragrance in their breath. So that is an Saundarya Lakshanam, Samudrika Lakshanam. So it's Akritrima Hridya Gandham Ananam Yunam Pibatam Yunam Ratrishu during the night Yatra in Vasantaratu. These young men are Pibatam. They are Ananam Pibatam. They are enjoying or drinking that beauty in their face. So Pibatam Yunam, those young people, their desire is not na jahara, it is not removed. They constantly want to keep on looking at their faces and continuously appreciate it. Okay. This atra ivadinam tulyadinam cha padanam abhave api, even without tulya iva etc. You still understand that slishta visheshanaihi, because of the slesha yukta visheshanam, akshipta eva upama pratiyate. Upama is seen, akshiptam pratiyate, it is suggested. Evam jatiya kaha slishtopi yogyasya padasya prithak upadane anye api vedaha sambhavanti. Even so, we can use prithak upadane, means all three of these visheshanas were used for both upamanam and the upameyam. We can also have slesha, which is only upamana visheshanam or upameya visheshanam, or just which may not even be an upama visheshanam for both. Iti prithak upa we can have. Yeah. We can have two different upamana upameya for both of them. That's what he's saying by prithak. Te api anaya eva disha drishtavyaha. So we can have many different kinds of yatireka. It's left to the sahrdaya and left to the pratibha of a poet to try to give different types of yatireka. It's so anantyam eva. प्रतिभा आनन्त्यात् अत्र काव्यविशेषाणामपि आनन्त्यम् अलङ्काराणाम् आनन्त्यं तस्मात् काव्यविशेषाणामपि आनन्त्यम् Nobody explains it better than ध्वन्यालोककार. This is just divisions that he gives with उदाहरणं for us to understand, but concept wise you should look at it in चतुर्थोद्योत in ध्वन्यालोकम्. Okay, I think I'll stop with this.